So I am Harsh from Nagpur, India. I did my BTech from VIT University, Vellore, and I am currently working as a blockchain developer at Anworks. The project that I was involved in was to give Aries the functionality to support Fabric as a ledger. And the Hyperledger projects that I worked with in this mentorship project was were Fabric and Aries. I was mentored by Kamlesh Nagware, sir. So I would just first give a project description. Aries is basically a wrapper around Indie and Ursa, such that it enables businesses to build self-sovereign identity solutions. Now, in these solutions, an issuer can issue a credential to a user, and this credential would only be kept in a wallet. And this user can verify to the verifier without even revealing the whole credentials through zero knowledge proofs. This works in two ways. Suppose, say, I'm a user and I have a credential of name Harsh and age 25. Now it's my choice that I can reveal that my name is Harsh to the verifier. And at the same time, it's my choice that I don't want to reveal my age. So the verifier would only check whether if my age is less than 30, and if my age is less than 30, it would be successful or else it won't be. This is what Aries India and Ursa supports. These can be any types of these can there can be any type of credentials, and various types of verification can happen. Now, businesses that are developing blockchain solutions using Fabric, say suppose supply chain solutions or solutions in telecom industry, they also want to carry out some sort of verification process, and their need is that they don't want to separate the data that they are putting into the blockchain. So they don't want their domain-related transaction to be in Fabric and the identity-related transaction to be in Indie. Once this project is developed, they would be able to use this Aries wrapper and only one solution, one blockchain platform they can use, that is Fabric, for all their needs. It would work for supply chain transactions as well, and also identity related transactions. So my objective here was to first develop a chain code in the Fabric network and integrate that chain code with AFJ. I also had to write the test cases in Aries framework JavaScript that would test the module that is written in AFJ that is integrated with Fabric. And the third objective was to demo this whole process of issuance and verification with Fabric as a ledger. My first deliverable was, see, there are three types of transactions that happen in the Indie ecosystem. One is domain, second is pool, and third is config. So as Fabric has its own similar types of pool and config transaction, we didn't need to support those transactions here. We only needed to support the domain transactions, which are these: DID, ATRIB, schema, cred def, revocation registry entry, and revocation registry definition. So we needed a chain code of that to be present in Fabric. My second deliverable was that there would be a module in AFJ that would interact with the chain code that we deployed in deliverable one. My third deliverable was to write test cases that would test this whole module and chain code thing. And the fourth one was to demo the issuance and verification with Fabric as a ledger. So we have been able to write the chain code and the module. This project that I was involved with, first it motivated me to look into how the Indie, Aries, and Ursa ecosystem work and replicate some of that functionality in Fabric. So we didn't need to entirely copy paste what Indie does. We picked up the SSI related part that Indie does and how it does it, and tried to replicate that in Fabric. So it gave me an understanding of how Indie works. And at the same time, as I was working on Fabric as a ledger and Aries framework JavaScript as a framework, I had to go and dig deeper into that also, and I had to understand it. One challenge that I faced here was while establishing connection from AFJ to Fabric. But this, when we later solved it, it improved my understanding of how a Fabric network works and gave me an understanding of what Docker networks are and how they work. We have some future work for it. Like right now, the domain specific transactions that I was talking about, there are 6 transactions. And currently Aries framework JavaScript only supports 3 of them, like DID, schema, and credential definition. They have plans for revocation and ATRIP transaction as well. Once that those are done, we would add that to Fabric as well as AFJ. One thing here that we are doing is, as we are using Indie wallet to store secret and non-secret records of credentials that are related to SSI solution to work, and we are using Fabric wallet to store client credentials. So we need to integrate, we can integrate that in the future and create only one wallet for it. And in the future, if the need arrives that any business that is using other blockchain platforms, and if they want to do their identity verification process in it, we can add those ledger as well. Now, this module would be added to AFJ. We have had a chat with the team, and the chain code would be submitted to Hyperledger Labs, and it would be taken forward from there. Now, as I said, I had two deliverables that I was talking about earlier. I had to write a test case and the demo of issuance and verification through Fabric. The second demo of issuance and verification, we are still working on it, but I have the test case prepared, so I would give a demo of it. Okay, so I am running Fabric in my local system. This is logs of one of the peers, and this is the logs of orderer. So I will just run the test cases here. Okay, so here it would write the DID, schema, and credential definition transaction in the Fabric blockchain. And so you would be able to see the logs of 3 transactions occurring here. Just give me a minute. So now the process has started just now. Yeah, so just a second. Yeah, The orderer has created block 6 and written it. It has come to the peer logs. The seventh block. So the same year, received block 7 and committed block 7. Now one more block would come. So the 8th block. Yes. And here we can see that all the test cases have passed. It has registered the DID, schema and credential definition on Fabric Ledger. We are in the process of creating the issuance and verification demo. Okay. So now the insights that I gained from this project was, whatever you are doing, first research on it and document the whole idea and a plan of how are you going to do it, then plan it and then implement it. Then the implementation becomes very easy, and in short, your life becomes very easy afterwards. And then try to have regular meetings with your mentor and exchange minutes of meeting emails from them with him or her. It would enable you to be in loop of what is happening in the project and what we are going to do forward. And if you are facing any issue, first try to debug it. And if it is not being able to solve, approach the open source community through GitHub issues or Rocket Chat. They are easily approachable and very helpful. Last but not the least, thanks to my mentor Kamlesh sir, he was available at various times, and he was also looking at my issues and researching with me. And also to the AFG team for their easy response, quick response for my issues, especially to Timo and Bernard. I'm over with my demo. Any question and answers?
So actually, Kamlesh here, I want to add, because I was the mentor of the project. So working with her is really great, and he's very dedicated, committed. Even we are schedule our meetings on the weekend, Sunday, every Sunday, 12 p.m. And idea about the project, because in the Hyperledger, we have number of projects, number of DLTs, and we have libraries, and the end goal of all these libraries and projects to work together and able to use each other's libraries. Like, for example, Explorer, currently we only use for Fabric. So it should support Beisu and Iroha and other Sartu kind of projects. Similarly, this AFJ, Eris framework, Java, JavaScript only support the Indie and Indie as a ledger. So having a Fabric as a ledger is really good move, and that's why we started and we proposed this project. And as a future goal, I heard and I'm thinking to propose this as one of the Hyperledger labs. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you both so much for presenting, and Kamlesh for mentoring and supporting your mentee. And it's great to hear that you are planning to propose this as a Hyperledger Labs project. So we're looking forward to hear more about it. And also the other demos you're working on, the issuance and verification.
Yeah. Sure. Thank you.
Yep. Thanks again.